S-Chan presents educational video lectures as per the AICTE curriculum. Difficult concepts made easy. Study anywhere, anytime.
So, hello students. Welcome to S-Chan Academy. In first part of the presentation, we discussed about the importance of effective communication at workplace. We talked about the verbal and non-verbal communication, why effective communication is important and how do we achieve that, and most importantly, what are paralinguistic elements. Now, coming further to the next part of the presentation, we will discuss what are soft skills and why are they important for success at the workplace. So, welcome to S-Chan Academy. I am Dr. Vidushi Bhardwaj. I will be talking about soft skills and most importantly, how can we achieve them at workplace. So let's okay. Welcome to S-Chan Academy. I'm Dr. Vidushi Bhardwaj. So if you want to explore further into oral communication, please refer to the book by Vikas Publications. Link of the book is given in the description box. Coming to part two of the presentation, we are going to discuss about soft skills, why are these soft skills are known as essential skills, which are essential for the professional development and workplace success. So, soft skills are essential interpersonal skills, any skill which is besides your hard skills, which is your technical skills or your degree or your qualification, and definitely those skills where you can tell the other person that you are very good at adaptability, how do you maintain relationships with other people, your attitude, your behavior, and your overall, life skills, what I would say. So it is not professional job specific skills like accountancy, graphics, or technical skills, but yes, they are the most important, most coveted skills, even more important than your technical skills, which are required by the industry these days. So they are your unique selling point. Number one, they give you a competitive edge over others in workplace and in life. And most of the times when you go for your recruitments, your placements, the industry and the people who come for the placements, the during the recruitment, they would assess your soft skills very easily through your group discussions and your interviews. So other name to soft skills which has been given is, it is also known as people skills, interpersonal skills, and social skills. So technically speaking, you would have your technical skills as your degree or a qualification, but your soft skills can be assessed by different ways, and they have their own ways to check that. So that is the reason why most of the times when you go for placements, they would assess your soft skills through your group discussion activity, your teamwork skills, and of course, whether you are aggressive or assertive or submissive or the one who is adaptable in a group. So that is the reason why people say that you should have, good soft skills in order to achieve success in workplace. Now, we already discussed, it's a cluster of personal qualities, your habits, your attitudes, social graces that make someone a good employee and compatible to work with. So we need to have soft skills in order to achieve some kind of identity, or probably I can handle interpersonal relationships well or not, I can communicate with others effectively or not, or I can have a good impact or impression on others or not, will be assessed by the soft skills I possess as an employee of the organization. Now, what are the objectives of learning soft skills? So, can it be learned? That is what, most of the times people are confused about. Like any professional degree or a technical competence, can soft skills be learned? We'll discuss about this also a little later. But yes, we can bridge communication gaps if we communicate well. We can enhance team building, we can increase my chance of employability if I bear good soft skills. I can enhance my public speaking skills, my presentation skills, and I can develop my interpersonal skills as well. So, what are the most important sets of soft skills or social skills which are required in the industry these days? So, there has been a lot of discussion on this, there have been a lot many researches on this, And it has been found that communication skills is the most coveted, most important skill which the recruiters look for, besides, of course, the technical skills. So it includes verbal and non-verbal. We have already discussed this in part one. Then comes the leadership, interpersonal skills, creativity, professionalism, etiquette, attitude, and behavior. Now, when we talk about leadership, it's important to possess leadership skills so that I can excel in my workplace. I can lead the team. I can make sure that, yes, the output-driven things are done, and I can succeed while working in a team as a leader. So this is how, you know, leadership is important at the workplace, especially for the people who have just joined their new institutions. So it comes with time. You learn it gradually. But of course, as a leader, I can show whether I can build my team, I can plan strategically, I can supervise my team, I can be involved with decision making or not, I can delegate responsibilities to my team members or not, I can mentor my team members, or I can give feedback or not. So this is something which will be assessed through my leadership skills. Then, of course, my interpersonal skills will decide whether I'm good at networking with people. Now, networking, where my aim is not to take an advantage of somebody, but yes, networking, where I can utilize my network for my professional development also. So my interpersonal relationships, how do I handle them? How do I deal with difficult people at workplace would be assessed through my interpersonal skills. I cannot keep fighting with people. If there is an issue, some kind of incompatibility in terms of working in a team, how do I deal with such people? Conflict resolution, how do I handle conflict in my team? That's very important, a quality which will be assessed through my good interpersonal skills. My personal branding, how do I brand myself as a professional? So how do I tell others that I am different from others? What is my unique selling point? Why should people come to me? What should they come to me for in terms of my professional expertise is something which is known as personal branding. And how do I stay away from office politics? So if we understand these things, as a professional, and we try to improve upon interpersonal skills, we will automatically achieve all this. Then comes the creativity. Now, creativity at workplace is a very, very important tool which makes me different from others. So my creativity will be displayed through my problem solving, my innovation, my designing sense, artistic sense, critical thinking, and troubleshooting. Critical thinking, where I can think critically instead of, going in one direction, I can critically analyze the situations. And if I'm really creative, I can be creative even with any kind of profile I'm given, even as an engineer or a management trainee or even a tax consultant. If I'm really creative, I'm going to do my task in a different way, which can help me achieve my aim at the workplace. Then comes my professional skills. Of course, how friendly I am, how is my work-life balance, my EQ and my IQ, do I have a balance between them, my intelligence quotient and my emotional quotient, both are equally important for me as a professional. How do I manage my time, my self-confidence, how do I take criticism, whether I like to be criticized or I take it positively or I take it negatively. I take it as a feedback to improve further or I take it, in a negative way. And how enthusiastic I am while I'm taking up a new job or a new role. So this all would be included in professional skills. And yes, it takes time to learn these skills. So how do we learn soft skills now? That is what we were discussing earlier also, whether it can be learned or not. The good news is that yes, it can be learned. And of course, boosting your soft skills will give you an advantage over others when you are applying for, some kind of a job role. If you can portray your soft skills in your interview or in your discussions with your recruiters, they will definitely choose you over others. No matter your technical competence, of course, would be equally good. They will be equally good, as you are. But if you are good with your soft skills, you can prove that with your examples and the answers you are giving, you will have an advantage over others. Some of the methods, how can you learn soft skills, would be, of course, a lot of practice. You can take up a course. There are plenty of courses these days. You can seek mentors. You can probably take help of your seniors, your professors, your teachers, or even your parents, your siblings, anybody who can mentor you on this. And you can volunteer by being a mentor to somebody whom you feel needs help. Now, what are the advantages of having good soft skills? We've discussed how do we, you know, improve upon them, how do we learn them, what are the ways of learning them, what are the different soft skills which are required. But now, what are the most important advantages are that you get new employment opportunities, people know you for your behavior, people recognize you, you know, as an employee you are recognized, you get promotions, you get advanced opportunities, you can have increased ability to perform on the job, you can create a strong team and people know you for your work, you get incentives, rewards and new challenges every day. So in nutshell, you know, communicating at workplace is definitely, it's not a very simple, you know, thing to understand. And effective communication needs a lot of practice and of course, a lot of effort from all of us. So you can pick up one skill, you can work on it and you can practice. And if you have any difficulties learning this, you can always seek the help of a mentor or somebody you trust. So in this part of the presentation, we discussed in detail about the soft skills. How do we learn soft skills? Why effective communication at workplace is important, especially in terms of achieving those soft skills? And how do we groom ourselves in terms of our etiquette, behavior, attitude building, and other skills related to workplace communication? Thank you. So if you want to explore further into oral communication, please refer to the book by Vikas Publications. Link of the book is given in the description box. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe and press the bell icon for future updates. Thank you.
All rights reserved. This video has been prepared for educational purposes only. No part of it may be reproduced or copied without the permission of the copyright holder.